Greetings to you all. In April, I had a unique opportunity to visit the Science Museum IMAX in London while the GT projector was undergoing its semi-annual maintenance. During the maintenance, many of the projector parts are removed so the internal components and mechanisms could be checked, adjusted, and repaired if needed. Since all these parts have been removed, it is a great moment to have a look at the IMAX rolling loop and at the path of the film through the projector, which is usually hidden. Just before I start, I'd like to encourage you to subscribe to BoardTech channel. It is very important as your subscriptions are helping me to show you the backstage of great movie theaters. If you would like to support BoardTech channel financially, you can use the Super Thanks feature here on YouTube or consider becoming a patron on Patreon. You will find all the useful links in the description down below. Every 6 months, IMAX GT projector has to undergo a maintenance procedure. No one would argue that the stakes are high and a lot has to be done to prevent any malfunction during a sold-out screenings. The projector has hundreds of moving parts inside. Every single one of them has to be checked. By the way, it is not enough to be just a skilled mechanic to service the IMAX film projector, you also have to be a bit of a plumber, as parts like lamps and mirrors are water-cooled. As you have probably noted, the lens and some of the side panels have already been removed. To demonstrate how the film runs through the projector, Matthew will remove a few more parts, including the upper deck output stator, the deck separator, the part which I dubbed a remote finger, which creates the loop on the output side, and the lower deck output stator. Now, when the output side is fully stripped down, Matthew will explain how the GT projector works.
This is a slot in a rotor where we create the loop. There's air jets here, so when it's spinning around, as the loop is formed, it makes a little pop on the film. So to stop the film from stretching, a little air jet is there to cushion it. Then we have a segment of rotor here, which is a projector film. Then we have a shutter here, which is flickers the same image. And then the same image is shown again in this section. So one image flickered and the same image is shown again before then next loop comes in, projected, flicker shuttered, projected again, next image comes in, same again, same again, same again.
I am hoping that it's very exciting for you to see the insides of the IMAX GT projector. If this is the case, please give this video a thumbs up. Let's see what else Matthew has to show us.
So we have our lenses already removed, so that's all we need to do for this. Taking the whole lens block apart is unnecessary for when we're doing servicing and cleaning, so we leave that on.
Now Matthew will carry on and strip down the input side of the projector. Here comes the stator, the deck separator with the cam unit attached, and the base of the deck separator. The lower deck stator will stay in place, so Matthew could lace a strip of film for the sake of demonstration.
We've laced up the film, now it's locked into the gate and in frame. We can now concentrate on creating the loop. So we dropped it in there, we closed the input stator, and then we start to create the loop here. So I just push a little bit of excess film through here, and as long as I push enough, it will automatically make the loop. So I can put too little in and it won't make the loop properly, but I can push as much as I want in there. So as soon as it sort of misses the rotor there, and then we slowly start to turn it until there's a bit of a click there. So that click indicates to me that the air jet's taken off and our loop's locked in. And if you see along here a little bit further, this place here, that's where the loop is starting to create for the next
one coming. Okay.
So now I need to lock in the output side. So let me get my bearings. So yeah, we're going to create the output loop now. Previously, like we said before, you'll have your remote finger. So now we've got that, everything's removed. I can actually get my hand in here, just like in the input side. So now I'm just going to frame it up. So look, we're looking at about, with no loop, it's about three perforations. So I'm just creating a loop which is three perforations big until my frame line is there to say I'm in sync. And again, it's important that whilst this isn't going on screen afterwards, it needs to be, the loop needs to be the correct size, because if it's too big or too small, it's going to cause issues and damage potentially as it comes out of the projector. So there's a loop we just created a minute ago. And if we keep an eye on this cam arm and the loop, as it goes and enters into the block here, the lens block, the cam arm starts to engage now. Can you see it just starts to move and it goes and catches the film and to decelerate it. Now we're projecting the image that is now holding the film still. So this part of the film is not moving anymore. And as it comes here, as you see, the loop's starting to build. As soon as we start to turn this, that loop builds. That little click is the air jet. It's not on at the moment, so it'll be a different sound, but that's the air jet going. Then it comes through, builds the whole loop, and the same thing happens again. As it enters there, that starts to move. Can you see how I rock it backwards and forwards? I'll make it really distinct for you guys. Yep. There we go. Now if I do it slowly, it catches, decelerates, builds. Comes out as a full, and dissipates.
So that was an IMAX rolling loop. As a bonus, Matthew took off the front panel so you could see two 15,000 watts xenon lamps and a set of mirrors which deflect the light into the lens. These lamps produce a lot of heat, so the anode and the cathode are water-cooled. And this is not all. Mirrors which are blasted with a 15,000 watt light beams are also water-cooled. That was a demonstration of the IMAX rolling loop and a rare opportunity to see the inside of the GT projector. I am very curious to hear what you think of it, so please share your thoughts in the comments down below. This is it for this video, thanks for watching and I'll see you soon. Goodbye!